As another measure of support, the National Backward Classes Finance and Development Corporation, NBCFDC, was set up by the Government of India in 1992. This finance corporation was set up by the Government of India in 1992 to provide financial support to the backward classes. With the object of providing concessional finance to members of the backward class living below the poverty line for the income generating activities. And the financial support was provided to all those persons who were living below the poverty line so that they may start generating income by the help of the financial support by performing certain activities. Thus, in India, the backward classes have been broadly divided into SCs and STs, and number two, other backward classes. SCs and STs enjoyed all the benefits for all these years after independence provided by the compensatory discrimination. So, whatever benefits were provided by the compensatory discrimination after the independence of the country, they were all enjoyed by the SCs and STs. Policies regarding OBCs differ from state and different groups of people are included. So, and the policies related to OBCs, they are different in different states and for different groups it is different. In some states, the Muslims are also included in the list of OBCs. The OBCs have a very different position in Indian society from that of the SCs, and victims of active social discrimination through segregation of STs who are in isolation. In general sense of usage, the backward classes mean the other backward classes, OBCs, who are socially and economically backward. Now, struggle for women's equality and rights. The biological differences between men and women, that is gender inequality, is often treated as natural. Sociologists have shown that the inequalities between men and women are social rather than natural. There are no biological parameters that can explain why so few women are found in position of public power. Nature cannot explain why women generally receive a smaller or no share in family property in most societies. The strongest argument comes from the societies that were different from the normal or common patterns. If women were biologically unfit to be inheritors and heads of families, how did matrilineal societies, as the Nairs of Kerala used to be and as the Khasis of Meghalaya still are dwelling? So it means that the Nairs of Kerala have a system of matrilineal society where the women is given more, has the more power in the family, and the Khasis of Meghalaya, they are yet following the matrilineal pattern of family. Therefore, there is nothing biological about the inequalities that mark the relation between men and women. Thus, gender is another form of social inequality and exclusion, like caste and class, but with its own specific features. In short, we can say that the difference between the men and women, or the discrimination among the men and the women in the society, is not a biological difference. It is because of the social because of the social differences which have been created by the society itself. The women question became prominent in the 19th century middle class social reform movements. The nature of these movements varied from region to region. They are called as middle class reform movements because many of the reformers were from the newly emerging Western educated Indian middle class who were inspired by the democratic ideals of the modern West and by a deep pride in their own democratic traditions of the past. So in the 19th century, some of the great social reformers, they started different movements at different parts of the country. The nature of these movements varied from region to region. And they are called as the middle class reform movements because the reformers were from the newly emerging Western educated Indian middle class who were inspired by the democratic ideals of the Western countries. The only example in this context are reformers such as Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Ranade, Dayanand Saraswati, Jyotiba Phule, and Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan, which are discussed below. Raja Ram Mohan Roy's movement at reforming the society, religion, and the status of women could be taken by the starting point of the 19th century social reforms in Bengal. Raja Ram Mohan Roy's reforms took place in Bengal. A decade before establishing Brahmo Samaj in 1888, he undertook the campaign against Sati, which was the first women issue to receive public attention. So in 1888, Raja Ram Mohan Roy was the first person who rose his voice against the Sati system. This became a movement, and this was the first women issue which was publicly acclaimed. His ideas presented the mix of Western rationalist and an assertion of Indian traditionality. He attacked the practice of Sati on the basis of both appeals to humanitarian and natural rights doctrines as well as Hindu Shastra. And to make his movement more powerful, he attacked the practice of Sati by building up a base of both appeals to humanitarian and natural rights doctrine as well as the Hindu Shastra. M.G. Ranade, the deplorable and unjust treatment of the Hindu upper caste widows was the major issue taken by the social reformer M.G. Ranade. He used the writing of scholars such as Bishop Joseph Butter, whose analogy of religion and three sermons of human nature dominated the moral philosophy syllabus of Bombay University in 1860s. So, M.G. Ranade, he was the person who raised the issue of widow remarriage, or may say, who took the the widows as his main base for starting a social movement for their remarriage. And he was impressed by Bishop Joseph Butler, whose analogy of religion and three sermons of human nature was taught in Bombay University in 1860s. His writings entitled The Text of Hindu Law on the Lawfulness of Remarriage of Widows and Vedic Authorities for Widow Marriage elaborate the Shastric sanction of widow remarriage. And he wrote a book called The Text of Hindu Law, and in this book he raised the issue of a remarriage of widows by proving it to be lawful in Vedic literature and in terms of Shastras. Jyotiba Phule was from an oppressed and socially exclusive caste in Maharashtra. He questioned the supremacy of Brahmins and the authority of the scriptures. He established Satya Shodak Samaj, condemned the caste and gender discrimination. So Jyotiba Phule, he himself was from a low caste, and he questioned the supremacy of the Brahmins and the authority of the scriptures, and he established the Satya Shodak Samaj and condemned the caste and gender discrimination. He founded the Satya Shodak Samaj and its primary emphasis on truth seeking, and the main focus of this body was truth seeking. His first practical social reform effort was to, and the groups considered lowest in traditional Brahmin culture, women and untouchable. And he focused on the women and the untouchables, which were the lowest group considered by in the traditional Brahmin culture.